Mike Demergis for the Kings, Scott Engel for Roto Experts at the Park, Chicago deep dish style. And Scott, we're talking about the Chicago Cubs, who are heating up, and it has a lot to do with their first baseman, Rizzo.
Yes, Anthony Rizzo only hit 158 in the first month, and fantasy players were getting very concerned about him. But then he had a terrific May, turned it around, really swinging a lot more pitches inside the zone, which is a key. But baseball's a constant game of adjustments. And if you're patient, you knew what you were going to get with Rizzo. His month of May was one of the best in team history in terms of RBI coming into the weekend series against the Mets to finish May. His 28 RBIs were the most in a month of May since Alfonso Soriano in 2008. And I spoke here to Anthony Rizzo about what turned it around for him in the month of May as we enter June.
Stayed with it. You know, it's baseball. You're going to have good days, you're going to have bad days, you're going to have good streaks, you're going to have bad streaks, and it's a game of 700 at-bats. It's not a game of 100, so you gotta keep the big picture in mind when the small picture isn't coming out the way you want it.
There's something like that, though, you know, as long as you've been playing the game. Like you say, baseball is a constant game of adjustments, but do you come out of a month like that even mentally stronger than before?
Bad months, bad stretches, it's kind of what determines you as a player, because anyone could be good. It's easy to be good and walk around and happy. Everyone loves you. Everyone's writing good things about you when you're good. But it's when, you know, those rough patches is how you handle them and how you come over those.
And Scott, another guy that's been heating up is a second baseman, Javier Baez, known for his defense, but his offense has really gone to the next level now.
Yeah, he wasn't always known for his defense, as Arnando DeFino points out. He had 44 errors in the minors one year, but in the majors, he's really turned it around. He's been doing it for fantasy players since the beginning of the season. The only type of format in fantasy where he annoys you a little bit is if you're playing on base percentage. He's only got 7 walks coming into the first game of June. But, you know, that's not a lot to complain about with Javier Baez. And we asked the broadcaster from the Chicago Cubs, Jim Deshaies, the former major league pitcher, about what statistical goals that Baez can get to this season.
He certainly has the power to hit 30 home runs. If I was trying to handicap it, I would probably tilt a little bit towards yes on 30 home runs, but I don't feel real confident about it. You know, I think he's a solid 20, 25 home run guy. You know, certainly 2020, and in the right environment, he's capable of stealing 30 bases.
Okay, Scott, the offense is starting to get going. So is the starting pitching staff. But according to pitching coach Jim Hickey, they haven't started to do enough just yet.
But this pitching staff as a whole, I would say, has underperformed as a whole just because of some inconsistencies in the ability or the inability to go a little bit deeper into the games. But a lot of that stuff was also our decision to remove a pitcher from the game earlier than you normally would for a pinch hitter, or just because our bullpen was so good or the bullpen was rested at that particular time. But I think you'll see us take a couple of turns through the rotation, and I think it might be happening right here, right now, where you get the 10 or 11 or 12 consecutive good starts and you win 8 or 9 or 10 of those ball games, and that's how you separate.
Well, Hickey isn't exactly throwing the starting rotation under the bus there, but he wants more, of course, from that starting rotation. One guy that's been pulling his weight has been Jon Lester.
Yeah, Jon Lester was a fantasy disappointment last year, but certainly turning it around for his owners this year. Unfortunately, when you look at his xFIP and his FIP, it points to some regression. So maybe you want to sell on Jon Lester if somebody still believes in that. But you know, Lester just talked to us about how he feels this year. It's just about feeling good physically. That's a big reason why he thinks he's off to a good start so far in 2018.
I think big thing is that I just physically feel a lot better than I did last year. So, you know, the maintenance in between starts is a lot easier. And like I said, I physically feel better every time I go out there. So I put myself in a little bit better position.
Scott, I'm going to throw a stat at you. Back in 1975, Catfish Hunter threw 328 innings. How about that? But Kyle Hendricks is looking to get 200 innings. That's what he's telling the media.
Yeah, that's his goal so far this year. And he's gone deep into games. And first, we spoke to Jon Lester about the fact that his teammate is going for this goal, and here's Lester's comments on Kyle Hendricks.
You know, to get to that number is a little bit of luck, and you know, on the days that you pitch, if we score runs, and you know, last start he threw, I think, 70 pitches and got pulled after 6 or 5, so, you know, it's hard to get to 200 innings like that, and that's, you know, I mean, that's a National League game, so, you know, hopefully that we can get him some runs early, and you know, Joe can let him go, and he can pitch deep into games, and you know, get to that number. I know that's, you know, a lot of people's number to get to, and it's always kind of self-gratifying when you're able to do it.
So the leader of the staff, Jon Lester, thinking that Hendricks could really get those 200 innings, and Hendricks himself believes he can get it done as well.
Yes, he did. He talks about that right here, about what's it going to take to get 200, to get to 200 innings, because he hasn't done it yet so far in his career, but fantasy players would love to see it happen.
You put a lot into that in the offseason, but you got to get into your routine, you know, stay, work out, do your cardio. You just have to find a good routine that works for you, that you stay healthy, that you can be out there every fifth day. So for me, I found that early. Luckily, I had some good coaches in the minor leagues, and I've had a very similar routine for years now. So I think that helps me a lot, just staying healthy and getting back out there for every fifth day.
And Hendricks, who went to Dartmouth, he's nicknamed the Professor, but that's not the reason why he's called the Professor.
Yeah, the reason why he's called Professor, especially a lot of Cubs fans, comparing him to Greg Maddux. And fantasy players have always been wary of a guy like Hendricks because he doesn't strike out a lot of hitters. But the numbers have always been there, and he realizes he's going to get to 200 innings, which he never has done before. He's going to do it on guile. And here he talks about his pitching style. He doesn't dominate opposing hitters, but yet he still gives you the fantasy numbers that you want.
I got to mix speeds, change, you know, mix locations, change eye levels with hitters, just keep their timing off. It has to be part of my game. You know, I don't have overpowering stuff that I can just get by out there throwing. So I think I have to pay attention to who these hitters are, what their approach are, so I can go out there and actually pitch.
Scott, before we get to the bullpen with Brandon Morrow, let's talk about Jose Quintana, who's really kind of not lived up to all he was expected to.
Yeah, you know, this is a guy that got from the other side of town. There was a lot of hype. But he's had four starts already with four runs or more, two with six or more. But coming into when we record this, two of his last three starts, six-inning shutout ball, seven-inning shutout ball, and Jon Lester, the veteran, watches his teammates like a coach, talks about how he's turning the corner here.
You know, he's made some better pitches in some key moments. You know, and I think that's really any start. You know, there's always going to be, you know, one to two spots in a game that can change your game. So in those situations, he's done really well. And so that, you know, that shows in the line score at the end of the game with no runs. So, yeah, I mean, I think, you know, some of us get going different ways, and he's going right now, and that's all that matters. So we just keep turning it over to him.
Moving to the bullpen now, Scott, pitching coach Jim Hickey says that Brandon Morrow has been nothing less than spectacular this year.
Yeah, the guy has made a transition from being a career starter who was very injury prone. He had eight saves in 2008, but never really became a closer, and then was a really dominant setup man for the Dodgers this year. The Cubs decided to give him a chance, and he has been lights out, terrific for fantasy players. He stayed healthy. A lot of fantasy players and fans didn't know if Morrow could be the guy, but now he doesn't worry you about a fantasy closer. And he used to throw five pitches, but now he's pretty much got it down to three, trimmed the arsenal, and is throwing very, very hard, especially with the fastball and the cutter.
His performance so far has been great. His performance last year in the second half of the season with the Dodgers was impeccable as well. And I had the pleasure of watching Brandon from the other side. He took a no-hitter two outs into the ninth inning against the Tampa Bay Rays a few years back, and it was one of the more amazing games I've ever seen pitched. It was an infield single, the 27th out of the game. It was an infield single, and he also struck out 17 that day, and he was really, really impressive. But he's been nothing but impressive here so far as well.
That wraps things up for the first At the Park of the season. He's the King, Scott Engel. I'm Mike Demergis.